Ching. Some songs together, and Johnny Cash recorded some songs of Bob Dylan's. Namely, this next one, well, you probably know the song because it was a hit by the Turtles, but it was also done by John and June. And to do that today, John Carter Cash and Anna Christina.
That deserves a great bit of recognition. And I got the feeling that I'm not alone in the appreciation for this music. How about it? What about thanks for hanging in there through the rain. They always say if you don't like the weather in Nashville, just hang on about 10 minutes, it'll change.
Thanks for being so patient. welcome.
Yeah, thank you for being so patient. And how about the long players?
Yeah, buddy.
It's great to be up here. This is the lovely Anna Christina, my girlfriend. It's great to be performing with her tonight. Thank you, Mr. Al Cooper. Incomparable Charlie McCoy. And back here behind me is going to be playing for you a little bit later on, doing one of his father's songs, Mr. Jamie Hartford. He's going to join us on this.
That's pretty cool.
My parents, Johnny Cash and June Carter, took to the stage the first time to do a duet in 1962. And this is the very first song they ever performed together. They were both fans of Bob Dylan, so they knew the lyrics before they got on stage. It was sort of spontaneous. This is It Ain't Me, Babe. Shortly after the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band did their Will the Circle Be Unbroken album, that was such a masterpiece and also such a groundbreaker. And Earl Scruggs reviewed their own record where they invited a lot of pop singers to come in and do some country songs. And Linda Ronstadt was one of those singers, and she sang a song called Silver Wings, Merle Haggard song. You guys know that one, right? And to sing that song, we have Britt Ronstadt with us today.
Yeah.
just getting started.
Our own Brad Jones on the low harmony, Chris Carmichael on the fiddle. It's a family affair here today. Say hello to Jamie Hartford. On the bass guitar, Mr. Norbert Putnam.
Yes! Yeah! Yeah! Woo!
Norbert played bass starting in Muscle Shoals. I don't know if you guys saw that movie about Muscle Shoals, but he was in the first Muscle Shoals rhythm section, then later came to Nashville and conquered the world. that's a lie, but I say he produced Jimmy Buffett and Dan Fogelberg, so how about that? Jamie?
Thank you.
Jane Hartford. Give him a hand, come on. Oh my goodness, time has come in the show to do a Paul McCartney song. Did you guys know Paul recorded in Nashville in 1974?
Yes.
Well, he did. He was over at the Sound Shop. And there's a man here today named Ernie Winfrey. I hope he's still around. Ernie, are you out there? If not, he may have gotten rained out. Where? Oh, there's Ernie right over there. Everybody say hey to Ernie real quick. Ernie recorded this song, and he also recorded a song called Junior's Farm. It was a Paul McCartney classic. But this was a song Paul wrote while he was in Nashville. He had the Nashville bug, and he wrote a country song. Now, I need some help on this, so I'd like to ask Kathy Matea to come out. Kathy, will you be my Linda?
Yes, darling.
Thank you, okay. Okay, good. I don't. All right, here's a song called Sally G. Hope you like it. Down in Nashville town, I met a pretty be back. She'll be back. To introduce you to a newcomer to town. I just met this fellow a few minutes ago. He's one of my dearest friends. We've made many records together, written many songs together. Mr. Randy Foster. You got a whippersnapper?
Y'all are sounding fantastic, and I love that y'all are out here braving this way for this time.
We're going to do a song that is on the seminal Birds album called Sweethearts of the Rodeo. And it was cut, part of it was cut here in Nashville. And Graham Parsons and Bob Buchanan wrote this song. Radney sings the hell out of it. And he's got nice boots on too, if you can see those.
I figured if you're going to sing a Graham Parsons song, you better wear some boots that are going to make Graham proud. There you go. Oh,
Who knew that Neil Young did one of his albums here? Yeah? Over a quad that Norbert Putnam and David Briggs owned, he cut an album called Harvest. And to sing the big hit from that record, our pal, you've seen her once on stage already, just Kathy Mattea.
I learned this song when I was in high school. It's kind of funny to be standing here in the middle of downtown Nashville playing it for you guys with gray hair. Fun.
Records coming to Nashville, or being recorded here in Nashville. Another one was the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band came to Nashville. And they've done three rounds of this album now, but the first one was trying to get the country establishment to play with some Colorado and California hippies. Was probably an experience itself. Mr. Jeff Hanna is with us today.
Night. You guys are awesome for hanging in there with the weather. It was worth every minute, wasn't it? Some major picking of something. Yeah. I get to sing a birds tune here. Let's do this thing.
The band, the Area Code 615, actually got together really on account of this man coming to Nashville. Say hello to Michael Nesmith. Get Norbert on bass on this one too. We need a bass player, and we need to be Norbert. Uh-oh, I can't tell that joke. Okay, what did the pirate? What did the pirate say on his 80th birthday? I'm 80. It only gets worse. There's Norbert in the bass. Saved. You're saved. So this was cut in 1968, is that correct? Yes, sir.
1968, RCA Studio A. David Briggs, Norbert Putnam, Lloyd Green. Maybe Wayne Moss. The guy.
And David Briggs, is he still here?
Right, George D.B.
Well, David Briggs, if you're here, come on up and play on this. There you go.
Yeah, buddy.
He's here.
Yeah.
if I go everywhere. Let's get help singers back up here. Anyone who wants to come back up. CD. All right, Tracy's come out. Good, that's good. And come see the Lone Players. We're over at the Frisk doing the ZZ Stardust on July 31st.
Oh, cell phone.